Namaste, it's Evelina here. In this video, I will share with you three yoga postures which are really helpful to release the tension from the psoas muscle. Psoas muscle is the muscle which basically is attached to the front of our hip, to the femur, and then it passes through all of our pelvis and it's attached to the lumbar area of the spine. So it goes through all this part of the body. And it's one of the hip flexors, so basically it's responsible for bringing your leg closer to the belly, to the chest. So anytime you are walking, you are lifting the leg, you are actually engaging that muscle. So most of our activities are including flexion of the hip. You are mostly flexing and not so often extending, so bringing the leg towards the other way. And in here, to release this tension, we will work actually with extension of the hip, with extension of the psoas muscle as well. So let's begin the first posture. I'm gonna bring the left leg forward as far as possible. So I want to have my knee really far away. You want to have as small angle in here as possible. You don't want to stay somewhere in here because then you are not flexing, not stretching, not extending anything in the front of your hip. So really focusing to bring it as far as you can. And then dropping your toes down, slowly staying in here. First inhale, opening your chest, exhaling here. If you feel that it's possible to even create more space, then walking your toes gently forward. And when you feel that that's all for you for today, then slowly lifting up. We really want to lift up because that's what is creating extension in the front area of the hip. Finding your balance here, breathing deeply, keeping your belly gently engaged. And then with inhalation, lifting your hands up. Exhale, sinking your hips as low as possible. Every inhale, opening the chest, lengthening the spine. And every exhale, lowering your hips a little bit more down. One more inhale, open. And exhale, deepen, slowly releasing your hands down. And then resting. Taking a moment to notice the difference. So if you feel that there is a lot of tension in your psoas muscle in the front of your hip, you would like to keep this posture for a little longer, for maybe 10 breaths. Then stepping your right foot forward and the same thing, creating lots of space between your heel and your knee. Slowly breathing here, finding your balance, finding your proper distance, and then inhale, lifting up. Exhale, lowering your hips deeper. Inhale, lifting your hands up, and exhale, deepening, sinking your hips more. Every inhale, finding lengthening, elongation in the spine. Every exhale, sinking a little deeper. One more long, deep inhale. And exhale, sinking deeper. Slowly releasing your hands. And then releasing your leg. Next posture, posture number two. We will sit in Vajrasana, so the simple position. However, we'll bring our calf muscles out and gently open the heels. So then you want to sit in between your heels. Both heels are touching the hips and knees are as close as possible to each other. From here, slowly just placing your palms back. You want to ensure that you are rolling your hips in, pushing your pelvis forward, just rolling your glutes in, then you are flattening the lower back. And then slowly walking down, staying on the elbows. Maybe this is enough for you. Or if it's possible, if you feel like you're able to go one step more, then we will go down all the way, laying on the back. You want to focus to reduce the arch which is underneath your lower back. So we don't want to be pushing your chest up here. You want to try to tag your ribs more in to flatten a little more your body on the floor. And then stretching your arms behind you. We will stay here for 5 deep breaths. So long, deep inhale. Steady exhale. keep breathing deeply and steadily. Keep trying to lower your ribs more. Long, deep inhale. Exhale. Two more breaths. And last breath, deep inhale. And exhale. Slowly, first relaxing your hands, keeping your belly, your pelvis gently engaged, lifting yourself up, one step back to the elbows, and then slowly lifting yourself up all the way to the palms, and gently releasing your legs, stretching them, maybe little movement to relax the muscles, to relax your knees also. And last posture for today, we will lay down on the back. And I don't really have much space here, but we want to open the feet wide and then bring the knees in. So your knees should touch each other and the feet should be widely open. And then from here, slowly dropping your right leg down, right knee to the floor, and placing your left ankle somewhere in the middle of your right thigh. Then stretching your arms behind and staying here, breathing deeply, steadily. This is nice relaxing posture. However, try to gently engage your glutes and push your hip forward. So you should really feel nice stretch in this area of your body. Calm, deep breath, long, deep inhale. Steady exhale. Let's stay here for two more breaths. And last one. Slowly coming back to the center. We'll switch the sides. So again, opening your feet, collapsing your knees until they touch each other. And then dropping your left knee down this time, right ankle in the middle of right thigh, and slowly allowing your left leg to reach the floor or as close to the floor as possible. Keeping your belly gently engaged, your pelvic gently engaged. Feeling the stretch on the left side. So if you really struggle with the tension in the front area of the hips, I advise you to add it to your or daily routine or at least to do this exercises 3 times per week. So it can help you during quite short time to feel more relaxation in that part of your body. With the next inhalation, slowly coming back to the center. Taking a moment to rest. So now just tucking your pelvis in, bringing the lower back flat on the floor, belly sucked in. And slowly making your way up to seated. That's it for today. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this practice and it was helpful for you. If it was helpful, please do subscribe, share, and stay tuned for the next videos.